Hello from the Bureau of Meteorology, with the outlook for severe weather in the coming months. Although severe weather can occur throughout the year, October to April is the peak time for Australia's tropical cyclones, floods, thunderstorms, bushfires, and heatwaves. On average, 11 tropical cyclones develop in the Australian region each year, and an average of 4 cross our coast. Last season, we had an unusually low number of tropical cyclones. 3 developed in the Australian region, the lowest number on record, and only 1 crossed the coast. This season, we expect to see an average to above average number of tropical cyclones forming. The main contributor to this outlook is the La Niña-like temperatures in the Pacific Ocean. Warm seas to the north of Australia and in the eastern Indian Ocean may further help fuel cyclone development. These patterns are also associated with increased rainfall and flood risk. Winter 2016 was Australia's second wettest on record. Above average rainfall has continued into spring, with September receiving almost 3 times the normal rainfall for the month. This means soils are wetter than usual across large parts of the country, particularly eastern Australia. With the outlook for the remainder of the year for average to above average rainfall, soils are likely to remain wet, and we should continue to see higher than average stream flows in many areas. The risk of flooding is raised with any sustained or heavy rainfall in the coming months. Thunderstorms are a common occurrence during the warmer months, particularly in northern and eastern areas. Severe thunderstorms produce damaging winds, heavy rain, large hail, and sometimes tornadoes. With more moisture than usual in the atmosphere, this season may see an increase in severe thunderstorms over inland areas and along the Great Dividing Range. And remember, with all thunderstorms, there is still a risk of dry lightning strikes, which can spark bushfires. Thanks to the wet winter, the southern fire season could start a little later than normal. But the above average rainfall and temperatures have increased vegetation growth. This means the potential for fire will be high if this vegetation dries out in the heat of summer. This may also mean a later end to the fire season. Heatwaves can have significant impact on human health, agriculture, and infrastructure. Wet soils inland mean early spring heatwaves aren't quite as likely as in recent years. But periods of extreme heat are a risk in any Australian summer. And as our climate has warmed, the number of heatwaves has increased. So the outlook for severe weather is an average to above average number of tropical cyclones, a raised flood risk in many areas, the possibility of more severe thunderstorms in some inland areas, an increased bushfire potential later in the season, and heatwaves remain a risk this summer. Australia's weather can change quickly, so stay up to date with the latest forecasts and warnings on the Bureau's website. Follow advice from emergency services on what to do before, during, and after severe weather. And keep an eye out for our severe weather update videos. For the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Andrea Peace.